What's going on, guys? It's your boy MLQS Glitch here, and today I'm going to cut it short, but basically this is a comment. I'm not commentating throughout this whole entire footage, and it's just going to be quiet and just the game audio. There's a lot of potato moments because the aim is sensitivity is very slow, and there's also a lost connection which causes the game to cut back to another point period, but yeah, hopefully enjoy, and later.
Changes. In 1776, this great nation accepted that armed conflict was the only way to preserve our rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If our founding fathers could only see us now. From Antietam to Amiens, Okinawa to Anchorage, we have fought. And now, the Red Menace is at our doorstep. Democracy itself is under threat of annihilation. That is why today, July 4th, 2076, 300 years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault Tech, but it was built by you, the good people of America, so that if the bombs do come, if the end does come, our way of life will endure. But not everyone will be saved. Those chosen to enter this vault must be our best and our brightest. For when the fighting is stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. So as we stand here today, we pray that the world will know peace. But if that is not our destiny, if war must come, we stand together knowing that here in Vault 76, our future begins.
I hope you all enjoyed the party last night, even those who may have overindulged and overslept. But it's time to get up and get out there. We've been locked away long enough. Today is Reclamation Day. It may be time to leave, but I'll never forget the day you all entered Vault 76. You come from every walk of life, every race, color, and creed. But you all share one very important trait. You are this country's best and brightest. But more importantly, you'll always be my family. have been tasked with nothing less than the rebuilding of America. Such a huge responsibility. Just know that Vault-Tec is proud of you. I am proud of you. When you hear this, it means I've been gone for several hours. I've got my own mission out there in Appalachia. This is the Overseer, signing off.
I feared you'd never wake up. Don't you remember? It's reclamation day. Time to leave the vault. Most of the others have already gone. Best get cracking. That's right, sir. Free samples. Yum, yum. Sir, Radex. I know it's cozy in here, but you'll soon be faced. Remember, you don't have to go it alone. Find friends or make new ones.
Overseer's log, or should I say, direct communication. Because whoever is listening to this had the moxie to try to find out where I've gone. But I'm glad you did. Truth is, I need your help. I've been given a task and I've decided to break protocol and tell you what it is. Because if there's one thing I've learned in these past few years, it's that we need to rely on each other. There were 3 active nuclear silos in Appalachia before the bombs fell. They blew up the world before. We can't let it happen again. So we've got to locate and secure all of the silos. Or die trying. Hopefully the former. But it's been 25 years. I just don't know what we're gonna find out there. Or where to start. My directive was to go to the nearest population center and assess the situation. I'll set up a camp on the way once I get my bearings. Find me there.
Rebuilding America. Glad I'm staying here. Never stop learning. Be the best that you can be. said she'd set up her camp down the road to the south.
Lumberjack Protectron does not want to lose lumberjack job to key human labor. Please enjoy this complimentary sample of wood.
Thank you.
I knew this wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remembered, but... mutated animals? Haywire bots? No people so far. We have to be ready to rebuild in... what I can confirm is... hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault-Tec was prepared. You see this? The cooking station? The stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home base out there. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you've built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Great. Hello, survivors of this garbage dump. I'm Sophie, and this is my stupid survivor story. Let's dumb shit go. Oh, yeah. Before the bombs, I was a librarian. And now I can read everything all the... Overseer's Log, town of Flatwood. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church. People were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected.
We call it the Great War now.
Beings again.
It's not been long, and things have
while
been
you're
rough.
Here, why
welcome
not
to Survivor Stories.
I'm also been
on
two.
Me, a responder. I've been working with the responders for a couple of years now. I'm from Charleston originally, so it was easy to join up. What wasn't easy was the work. Rebuilding Appalachia from the rubble while survivors flock to us regularly
with
from all over.
And a little
so many have come and gone.
You'll do
stories
just
untold,
fine out there.
Names lost to time. I thought we should preserve this history somehow. I've decided to ask people to record their thoughts, their stories, anything they want to preserve forever. I'll call this series the Survivor
hey,
Stories.
Volunteer.
I'll start with me.
If you need
I was an anthropology
supplies,
PhD student
Bob
at Voltaic University.
Got you covered.
Final year. I was printing my thesis when I heard the sirens. I thought for sure my father, a Voltaic employee, could take us all with him, but only two reservations came through. I refused to go.
That overseer lady
went to the
said
vault.
More
they
people
could not persuade
would
me,
be
don't they
coming.
Try.
It's nice.
In the end, I
you.
Pushed them inside it, and that was it. After that, I went back home to Charleston and, well, survived. Eventually, the responders formed, and I signed up right away. It was
it sure
hard.
Is great to see living
blood
human beings again.
It was devastating. Relocating to Morgantown Airport and now Flatwoods has been... I remain optimistic. Been with them now for, well, I guess 2 years. We have
while
big plans.
You're here, why not
we
grab a stem
so
back
to help.
Or do?
Maybe, just maybe, we can rebuild enough to be okay. And in the meantime, I will continue to record stories of survivors when I can. We are your history.
Hey.
This
volunteer,
is on and off
if
now.
You need supplies, Bob's got you covered.
Tesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoka, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoka to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone, open kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
This is the end of the first hour of Fallout 76 that I played through. If you want to see more, just tell me in the comment section. And if you have any questions, just ask me. Also, look in the link in the description. You can find, like, my Twitch, Instagram, Twitter. And, yeah. Peace out.